Hey CFS Warriors, it's Victoria coming to you from Lake Tahoe, beautiful winter wonderland. And I just want to talk to you tonight about the importance of distinguishing between emotions that are coming up and thought patterns that need to be retrained. And I found it interesting when I was on a forum for brain retraining when someone said, I've been doing the process on this anger, but it keeps coming up. And no matter how many times I do the process on it, it won't go away. What am I doing wrong? Well, actually, they're not really doing anything wrong because that emotion doesn't need to be retrained. An emotion is a signal. It's a message from the body and it's a call to action. And so what that anger is trying to do is get that person's attention to take appropriate action so that then the body can stop sending that emotion to them. The thing about it is if we don't listen to those emotions, they can actually become symptoms. And so this was really important to me in my journey to learn this distinguishing point, the discerning point on this, because for me, I stuffed my emotions a lot. And I did a lot of work with Mickel therapy in order to become comfortable with my emotions, learn how to express my emotions. And then I got into brain retraining and I love brain retraining. So the things I like to use brain retraining on are things like beliefs, predictions, negative thought loops, states I want to get in, like relaxation, which is like a healing state, right? And I'm sure there are other ways I use it, but those are just the ones that come to mind. Now, on the other hand, Mickel talks about there are two types of emotions. One is a primary emotion that just is from the gut, and it's in response to any kind of situation or event in our lives. And the other type of emotion is a secondary emotion that comes from either dipping into the past or into the future, and it's generated by thoughts. So that is definitely a state where you go, I don't want that emotion because it's head-based and I need to do a stop on those thoughts. So you really want to be like a detective and go back to the source, back to that original situation and find out, what was the primary emotion? What was my gut response to that situation? And then what would be the appropriate action to take for that? And again, that way the body doesn't have to keep sending that signal, that emotion, and start screaming at you with a symptom. By listening to it and taking appropriate action, it can be resolved and then it lifts. So for example, the person that was angry in that forum, the thing that the emotion was asking for them to do was go back. Were they offended? Did someone mistreat them? What would be the appropriate action to take? Perhaps it would be setting a boundary with that person or speaking your truth and love to that person. So there are actions that the body wants us to take, and then it can relieve us of that emotion. An example of a head-based emotion on this would be if we're in the future, in our head, talking, in our, you know, having a conversation with someone. Have you ever done that? And you're gonna say this, and then they might say that, and you'll say this. Well, those are obviously head-based thoughts that are generating more emotions of anger. So that needs to be stopped, and then be like a detective, go back and find out what was that original emotion. Obviously, you have an issue with this person, it would seem like, so you'd wanna go back. What's going on? What's the emotion and what can you do about it? So anyway, Warriors, just wanted to share that with you. It's been a really interesting journey for me in recovery with learning to distinguish, you know, working with my emotions versus working with neural pathways and retraining those for healing. So anyway, hope that helps. Remember, life isn't over. It's starting again. And I speak life, health, and wholeness over you.